Subscribe to our channel and press the bell icon to get the latest notifications. Good morning, everyone. So as you can see that we are going to discuss the important current affairs for April 10th, 2019. And as you know, we are already providing the content on www.anujjindal.in. Apart from this, you can download the Infinity app from the Google Play Store, where you can find the PDFs and the quiz for the same. So let's begin with the first important news for April 10, 2019, which is the first railway station in India to get an ISO certification from the National Green Tribunal. So recently, this is for the first time that the railway station in India has got the ISO certification, that is 14001:2015 certificate, and that too has been given from the NGT, that is National Green Tribunal. So which railway station has become the first Indian railway station to get an ISO certification? That is Guwahati Railway Station. And they have been given this ISO certification from the NGT, the National Green Tribunal, for providing the best passenger amenities in the across the railway station. So Guwahati has been honored with the ISO certification, which is the first railway station in India to get such certification. The next question is, which of the following has emerged as the best educational institution in the country according to the National Institutional Ranking Framework 2019? Very, very important question. Mark this question. This is very, very important question. First of all, this National Institutional Ranking Framework 2019, this is given by the Ministry of HRD. That is the Ministry of Human Resource Development provides this National Institutional Ranking Framework 2019. And in the overall ranking, the first institute which has been, or the institute which has been ranked at the first position, is Indian Institute of Technology, Madras, that is in Chennai, Tamil Nadu. So this is the institute which has been ranked at the first position. If we talk about the IISS, that is Indian Institute of Science, Bangalore, so that has been ranked at the second position. The first is with this Indian Institute of Technology, Madras. Third position, that is Indian Institute of Technology, Delhi. For the fourth position, Indian Institute of Technology, Bombay. And the fifth position is of the Indian Institute of Technology, Kharagpur. So these are the top five institutes under the National Institutional Ranking Framework 2019. And this is for the overall ranking of these institutes. Now, if we talk about the rest of the categories, so if we talk about the universities, so there are other important categories, universities, engineering and management. So let's look at the first institute in the universities. So Indian Institute of Science, Bangalore, that has been ranked at the first position. The second position is of JNU University, that is Jawaharlal Nehru University, Delhi. The third is the Banaras Hindu University in Varanasi. So the Banaras University is at the third position. If we talk about the engineering category, so for engineering, the IIT Madras. For second, IIT Delhi. And for the third position, IIT Bombay. These are the top three rankings among the engineering institutes. For the management, the IIM Bangalore. The second position, IIM Ahmedabad. And for the third position, IIM Calcutta. So these are the top three institutes in universities, engineering and management. Now, what are the parameters which are being considered while we are taking care of this National Institutional Ranking Framework 2019? So the very first parameter is teaching, learning and resources. The another one is the research, professional practice and collaborative performances. Graduation outcome is the third parameter. Outreach and inclusivity is the fourth parameter. And perception is the fifth parameter. So these are the five parameters on which this National Institutional Ranking Framework is based, that too prepared by the Ministry of HRD. Moving on to the next question, and quite important question. The question asks which city has become the first city in the world to implement the special ultra low emission zone. Now, first of all, what are these ultra low emission zones? So ultra low emission zones are those zones where the daily vehicles would be charged with a particular fee, or the older vehicles would be charged with a particular fee if they do not meet the emission standards. So for the petrol vehicles and diesel vehicles, the emission standards are different. So if the vehicles are not meeting the Euro 4 standards for the petrol run vehicles, they would be charged in this ultra low emission zone. And for the diesel vehicles, if they do not abide by the Euro 6 standards, then they would be charged under the ultra low emission zone. Now, which country has become the first in the world to operate these 24 hours ultra low emission zones? So, London has become the first city in the world to implement these special ultra low economic zones. And they would be operational for 24 hours and 7 days a week. Moving on to the next question, SEBI in its first of its kind move has approved a specific fund. What is the name of that fund? So this is for the first time that SEBI has approved the airport specific fund. Very important question. Airport specific fund, and what is the name of the fund? So it is taking off to the future airport fund. So this is the name of the fund, taking off to the future airport fund, and it is very easy to remember. In fact, the sponsor and the management manager of this fund. So the sponsor and the investment manager of the fund is the Chennai based firm. So it is Chennai based firm, which is known as the Taking Off to the Future Investment Management LLC. So what would happen is, as the name suggests, this is the fund specifically for the airport. So it would be used for the development of the airports, and the investors would be start to get the returns from the fund from the third year. Now SEBI has launched this fund under the category 2 of the AIF. So this has been launched under the category 2, that is category 2 of alternate investment fund, and there are total of 3 categories under the alternate investment fund. So there are category 1, this is for the alternate investment funds, very important for the SEBI point of view, category 2 and category 3. The first category deals with the investments in the startups. So for startups or SMEs, this is the purpose for the category 1 alternate investment fund. Next is the alternate investment fund, which is used for the private equity, or which is the private equity fund or the debt fund, and the airport specific fund has been launched under the category 2. The last category is related to the hedge funds, where there is requirement or where there is view for the trade to earn the short term returns. So this is basically related to the hedge fund. So these are the 3 categories, and very, very important categories for the alternate investment funds. Next is, who has been conferred with the Sportsperson of the Year award in female category as per ESPN India Award for 2018. So according to this question, PV Sindhu was conferred with the Sportsperson of the Year award in the female category. If we talk about the male categories, so for the male category, Neeraj Chopra was awarded the Sportsperson of the Year award in the male category. There were other categories as well. So if you look at the other categories, the emerging sports person, next was the coach of the year, another one was the comeback of the year. These are the important announcements being made at the ESPN Awards 2018, and the last one was the lifetime achievement award. So for the emerging sports person of the year, Saurabh Chaudhary was being awarded. With which sport Saurabh Chaudhary is associated? Do mention your answer in the comment section below, that with which sport Saurabh Chaudhary is associated. For coach of the year, Jaspal Rana was awarded, and he is associated with pistol, the pistol shooting. For comeback of the year, Saina Nehwal was awarded. Saina Nehwal, and we all know she is associated with badminton. For the last award, that is the lifetime achievement award, Pradeep Kumar Banerjee was awarded, and he is associated with football. So what you need to answer in the comment section below, that with which sport Saurabh Chaudhary is awarded emerging sports person of the year. Emerging sports person of the year. So Saurabh Chaudhary, the sport with which he is associated. Next is, World Bank has projected the GDP growth forecast of India for financial year 1920, that is FY20 at. So for the financial year 20, India's GDP growth forecast has been predicted at 7.5%. So for this 7.5, that is D is the correct option. World Bank has projected the GDP growth forecast of India for financial year 20 at 7.5%. So as per World Bank, if we talk about the financial year 19, that is 2018 to 2019, the real GDP growth is estimated at 7.5%. 2%. Very important to remember these numbers. Next is, who among the following has been unanimously appointed as the 13th president of World Bank? Very, very important question. So, Davis Malpass has been appointed as the 13th president of the World Bank. Now, one question which can come from this static information is that who is the current CEO of World Bank? CEO of World Bank. You need to answer that in the comment section below. One hint regarding this question is that person was also the interim president till the time Davis Malpass has been appointed as the president. So, she was in fact the interim president of a World Bank till the time no World Bank president was there. Another question is, what is the theme for the World Health Day 2019? So, first of all, World Health Day is observed each year on 7th of April, and this year the theme was Universal Health Coverage, Everyone, Everywhere. This was the theme, in fact, for the 2018 as well. So, for 7th April 2018 and 7th April 2019, the same theme was similar. That is, Universal Health Coverage, Everyone, Everywhere. Now this World Health Day was first observed on April 7, 1948, basically to commemorate the establishment of World Health Organization. Next is, recently which country has become the fastest to send the supply ship to ISS in 3 hours 21 minutes? So, the supply ship of which country has made a record of reaching the ISS, that is the International Space Station, in 3 hours 21 minutes? So, from the Russian facility, the launch facility, which is in Kazakhstan, which has set a record time for a trip to the International Space Station in 3 hours 21 minutes. The earlier time was 19 minutes more than this one. So, what is the answer of this question? Russia is the country which has become the fastest to send the supply ship to ISS in 3 hours 21 minutes. It is unmanned Russian spacecraft. Remember this thing. It is the spacecraft from Russia. The last question for today is, Dash has announced its merger with the non-banking financial company Indiabulls Housing Finance. So, the board of the Lakshmi Vilas Bank has approved the scheme of amalgamation with the Indiabulls Housing Finance, which is the non-banking financial company. This merger actually needs the approval from the RBI. It has not yet been approved by RBI. And typically what happens is, the regulator do not agree with the bank license transfer as part of the merger. So, probably what would happen is, the bank license would lie with the Lakshmi Vilas Bank only, as RBI does not allow the transfer of the bank license to the non-banking financial company. So, why is this proposal for merger being there? Because the Chennai-based Lakshmi Vilas Bank, it is based out of Chennai. So, this Chennai-based LVB, that is the Lakshmi Vilas Bank, has breached all the parameters for the NPA all the parameters of coming under the PCA framework. That is actually the capital adequacy, the asset quality, the return on assets. These all parameters have been breached, and there are high chances that they might come under the RBI direction. So, therefore, to rescue kind of thing, the Indiabulls Housing Finance is acquiring or is amalgamating with the Lakshmi Vilas Bank. It is kind of a benefit for the Indiabulls Housing Finance, because they will be having the established part to enter the banking sector. So, this is all for the current affairs for April 10, 2019. Do not forget to mention all your answers in the comment section below. If you have learned anything from this video, do not forget to subscribe to our channel Anuj Jindal, and do press the bell icon so that whenever we post the current affairs video or any other video on the YouTube channel, you get the notification as and when the video is posted. Thank you so much for watching the video.